So we're going to have a go at making in Python the countdown, the TV show countdown numbers game. If you're not sure what this is, if you just type in numbers game countdown into YouTube, you'll find various examples of it. I've put the rules up here, but basically the game should generate six random numbers between 1 and 99, and then a target number, which is a number between 1 and 1,000. And then we have to use the random numbers to make the target number. So, for example, if we generate these random numbers and the target number is that, this formula would get to the target number and the contestant would win. So, what we want to do is have our program generate some random numbers for us. So, the first set of numbers need to be random numbers between 1 and 99. So we are going to start by importing random. Crikey, can't type today. So that will import all the things we need to perform the random calculations. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this into a function. Okay, so if you're not sure what a function is, have a look at the Learn to Code playlist on this channel, and that will explain what a function is. But basically, it's like a program inside another program that we can run at any point. So I'm going to make a variable name, and I'm just going to call it number one. And I'm going to do random.rand int 1 to 99. Okay, and what this means is we're going to make a random number, an integer, and it's going to be between 1 and the end will be 99, so anything between there. Okay, and just to make sure it works, we're just going to do print number 1. Okay, so we can see it printed out. So this will look after making a random number. Okay, now we can just check it works by coming out of the function and just calling the function name. Okay, so random and brackets. Okay, so hopefully this should give us a random number. So let's have a look. 36. Okay, it does. Good. So we know that's working fine. So for the minute, I'm just going to get rid of that. Now we need six random numbers. Okay, so I could simply do this six times. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and that would give us six random numbers. There we go. Not a massively efficient way to do it, though. What we would be a better way is using a loop. So we can set up a for loop, and we'll just call it for x in range 1 to 7. Okay, because we want the loop to run six times, because we want the random numbers generated. So it will start at 1 and go up to, but not including 7, so it will run six times. So I'm just going to go into the loop here and tell it what I want to repeat six times. And what it is the function name, random. Okay, so I want this function here to repeat six times. Okay, so let's just check if that works. Okay, cool. There we go. There's our six random numbers. So a bit more efficient than doing the function six times. Okay, good. So that's sorted. So we now need a way of generating a target number. So let's call it target num. Oops. Target num equals, and we just generate a random number in the same way we did above. Okay. random.rand int, and then the brackets are the starting points. We want it for three figures maximum, up to 1,000. So starting at 1, going up to 999. Okay, and then we can just wrap this up in a print statement. The number you have to make is. There we go. Target num. Okay, and you can see here we've separated the string Okay, which again, if you're not sure what a string is, check out the Learn to Code playlist, and the variable name with a comma. Okay, so let's have a look and see what we've got. Okay, good. So we've generated 6 random numbers, and the target number is 743, so the contestant would have to use these 6 random numbers to get as close as they can to 743. I'm not going to try and work that out because I'm not that great at maths.